Okay, so let's continue on with our admin support module. Now we are going to be talking about the calendar. So let's go ahead and check it. So go ahead and click this icon to get your apps and then look for calendar and just click on it. And you will get this dashboard. So this is your dashboard. Okay, let me just walk you through the different parts. Yeah. Okay. So this one will give you the main menu. This one will give you the sidebars as well. Okay, you can, and today more, you can move it by week. So you can check the last week. You can move it forward. This will set, so ito yung current month and year mo. If you're looking for a particular event, just click on search. And if you want to expand on your settings, so this is again your gear icon to click on your settings. Yan yung trash, yan yung siya makikita mo, and yung mga additional settings mo pa. Now you can set your view on a weekly day schedule. Pwede mo siyang iset sa monthly view for the day, year, or for 4 days. So it's all up to you. And so yan siya. So dito yan, meron kang maliit na by month na calendar. This show, ito yung time of the day. So currently is nasa dito siya. Ito yung time mo and date. Ayan. So pwede mo siyang iset. Then, kung ano ba may mga regular meetings ka with specific people, lalabas din siya dito. So, it makes it easier for you to find particular meeting schedules for particular people. Kasi pwede mo siyang yan check or i-check depending on the one that you're trying to search for. Okay. So, pag sinabihan ka ni client na, okay, set a meeting for this particular client, or whatnot, this is how you're going to create one. So click on this button, the create button. Yes. And then lalabas yung pop-up. So just set it. So let's say monthly meeting. Staff meeting, let's say. Staff meeting. Then. So is it an event? Is it a reminder or is it a task? So you can set it. So let's say it's just a reminder. Yan. Or task ba siya? Anong klaseng task? So pwede ka mag-add in description. Kita mo rin yung task mo dyan. Then just click on save. Pag reminder naman, it's for you. So pwede mo siya iset kung mag-re-repeat ba siya. Kailan siya mag-re-repeat. So it can be set kung daily, monthly, pwede mo na siyang i-customize. So let's say, gagawa tayo ng event so that we can also invite other people. So set it for event. And set the date. So let's say May 20th. Tapos, let's say, 2 p.m., let's say, 2, 3 p.m. Then, pwede mo ngayon ditong ilagay yung mga email address ng mga taong i-invite mo. Let's say, so, let's say, tapos, kung physical location siya, pwede mo ilagay dito kung saan siya, yung address, and then description, let's say. So, this is a monthly staff meeting to discuss goals. Ayan. Tapos, pwede mo na siya i-save agad Or we can also check kung ano pa yung additional options natin. Yan. So, if you click on more options, mas lalaki yung page mo to give you additional information. So, since it is a monthly staff meeting, pwede natin siyang iset to repeat. So, for you to be able to set that to repeat, just click this. And then, monthly. So, let's say, every end of the month siya. Repeat every 1 month. And then, on the 20th. And then, mag-i-end ba siya? Hindi. So, kung recurring naman siya, just put an never. And then, click on done. So, every 20th of the month, magre-recur tong event na to. Okay? Tapos, pwede ka rin mag-set ng notification. So, may two options ka. It's either mag-notify siya ng alarm. So, this one is 30 minutes before the meeting. You can set this as well. So, kung halimbawa gusto mo na 15 minutes lang halimbawa, it's up to you. You can do it by hour. So, 15 hours before, 15 days before, it's all up to you. So, pwede mo siyang iset. And, pwede rin naman na email yung notification mo, hindi alarm. So, you can set it as email. And, it will send you an email 15 minutes before. So, depende pa rin to sa kung ano yung isiset mo. So, pwede siya mag-alarm, notification alarm, or email. So, you can set that. Then, yan. So, kung gusto mong ma-notify ka ng alarm, ma-notify ka pa ng email, then you can do that too. Ayan. And then, once you're happy with all the information, just go ahead and click on save. Tapos, pag nag-save ka na, automatically ipa-prompt ka niya na mag-send ng invite doon sa mga email addresses na pinasok mo doon sa list. Automatically, magsisend sila ng invite. So, pag clinic mo yung send, automatically, may notify sila na they have been invited to attend the monthly staff meeting. So, let's say don't send lang. Yan, okay. Ayan, ayoko pa siya iset. Okay, so that's how easy it is for you to create an event. And makikita mo na siya ngayon, when you go to the 20th, naka-block na siya dito. Ayan. So that's how you make it. That's just simple. Ngayon, yan. Kung halimbawa naman, yan, check mo siya, mawawala siya. Diba? So, this is handy kapag marami kang, si client mo, maraming ka-meeting every week or every day, then it's easy for her to sort of sort it as well. Okay? So, that's how simple using the calendar is, but it pays to know because it is also common for clients to ask help na i-manage yung calendar nila.